With the team set up, we are now ready to do our title and abstract screening. As said before, you can do this either as a reviewer or as a researcher. Let's see how each of these would look like. All right, now I've logged in as Giraffe the Reviewer. I want to do title screening. I will open my project, go to title screening. For now, I will close the filter and the sidebar. So as you can see, there is a little progress bar up top, which shows how many papers I've already done and the percentage of each of my votes. And down here, you can see the actual papers and their abstract. As you can see, some papers only have titles and some papers have both titles and abstracts. Unfortunately, that's one of the issues when you download database entries where they would not provide abstract. As you can see, you have the option to submit either of the four votes. Yes and no are clear. Maybe is for cases where you want to raise a flag so that the researcher would further review it. And contact is for cases where you think that the author of the paper should be contacted for further information. In each of these categories, if you select it, there would be a drop-down of a list of reasons why you chose to reject this paper. And of course, this preset list of reasons can be changed later in project settings, which I will explain in another video on screening categories. One last point on this is that you can choose other and submit a manual point. For example, not sure about data and submit. Another feature here is this highlight bar where you can type in a few words that are relevant to your search, like market, promotion. And as you can see, these words are highlighted within the abstract and title of the papers I'm looking at. This can come in handy and make your reviewing of text faster. Okay, this is what the reviewers see in title screening. Let's see what the researcher sees. I'm the researcher in this project now. So if I go into title screening and let's close these sidebars, what I see is that Giraffe the Reviewer has submitted 8 votes, 4% of all the papers. And here I can see the votes that have been submitted and I can make a decision myself. As you can see, I have the option to reject or accept these papers into full text screening. What happens is that if I reject them, they will stay at this stage and will not proceed to the next stage of the project. But if I choose accept, they will be sent into full text screening. I also have another option, which is this double text in the end. If I choose that one, this will send my paper directly into data entry. This is for cases where I am 100% sure that there is relevant data in this paper and I want this to be included in the final sample. So with that, let's try some of these options. I will accept this one, and accept two of them directly into my data entry. So if I go into my full text screening, I will see the papers that were accepted and two of them are actually also accepted for data entry. If I go into my data entry, I will see these two that were accepted for data entry.